When we have analyzed the transshipment problem, we have seen that some optimization problem can be solved by ignoring the fact that the variables must be integer, but still were guaranteed to generate integer solutions. The property was called total unimodularity. Unfortunately, this is a specific property. It's not the most general case. And the problem that we have with the general case is that for discrete optimization, we have no optimality conditions that we can exploit for the algorithm, but also to make sure that we have found the optimal solution. Let's see an example of an integer optimization problem. We want to minimize a function of two variables x1 and x2 that are integers. And they are subject to two constraints, two linear constraints. 2x1 plus 9, x2 is less or equal to 29, and 11x1 minus 8x2 is less or equal to 79. The feasible set of this problem consists in the intersection between the polyhedron defined by the constraints and the lattice of all integer values, which is represented by these dots here. This intersection here consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, and 24 feasible solutions. So it's a finite set. Actually, one way to solve the problem would be by enumerating the solution. So what I can do is that for all of these 24 points, I can calculate the objective function and then identify the one which is the best. Let's do that. Here I have enumerated the 24 points that are feasible, which means that verify the inequality constraints and they are both integers. And for each of them, I have calculated the objective function. The best one is this one. The minimal value is minus 42. And the optimal solution is therefore x1 equals 1 and x2 equals 3. Let's use this enumeration technique for the knapsack problem, the binary knapsack problem. So we have n items. For each item, we need to decide if the item will be included in the sack or not. Therefore, we have a total of 2 to the n possibilities. And for each of these possibilities, we need to do two things. We need to check if the combination verifies the constraint, so if it is feasible, and then to calculate the objective function and store it. This takes about 2n floating point operations per combination. 1n for checking the feasibility to calculate the weight of the set, and 1n to calculate the objective function. Now let's assume that we have access to a processor which is able to calculate 1 teraflops. So this is 10 to the 12 floating point operations per second. If we want to solve an knapsack problem with 34 items, this problem will be solved in 1 second using the 1 teraflops processor. Now if we put 6 more items, it goes to 1 minute. To solve a problem with 45 items, it's about 1 hour. 50, we reach 1 day. 58, we reach 1 year. If we go to 69, the time to enumerate all the possibilities is 2,583 years, which is more than the Christian era. If you go to n equals 78, it will be 1,500,000 years, which is about when the Homo erectus appeared on Earth. It was 1,500,000 years ago. And the last example is that if n equals 91, we need 10 to the 10 years, which is basically the age of the universe. It means that even if you have a fast computer, to solve problems which are relatively small size may take a huge amount of time, like the age of the universe. Remember that the knapsack problem may be used in portfolio optimization, where an investor decides which assets to put in the portfolio. And in this case, the number of possible assets is easily exceeding 100. So applying complete enumeration in this case is clearly infeasible. You have probably heard about Moore's laws that says that the computing power of computers basically double every 2 years. So let's take the extreme case where our processor, which is 1 teraflops, has its capacity multiplied by 1,000. We use a 1,000 teraflops processor. But in that case, if I put the limit to 1 day of calculation, before I was able to solve a problem with 50 items, but with my new processor, which is 1,000 times faster, I can only solve a problem with 59 items. And for larger values of n, well, the total number of years is simply divided by 1,000. So going from the edge of the universe to 10 million years will not necessarily help. So it's not sufficient to wait for better computers. This problem is intrinsically difficult. This explosion of the computational time as a function of the size of the problem is sometimes referred to as the curse of dimensionality. In the absence of optimality conditions, an enumeration of the feasible solution looks like a good idea to solve a discrete optimization problem. However, the curse of dimensionality, which is a huge increase of computational time as a function of the size of the problem, does not allow us to do that. And we have seen that waiting for faster computers will not help. Therefore, we need to do something else. We need to find a better method, a more practical algorithm.